We'd love to have everyone join us. We'd love to stand around and look at all the artwork and have a little food, a little wine. So come and have our wine and cheese party with us Friday at 5:30. Thank you.
Thank you. increase and multiply upon us your mercy, that with you as our Lord and guide, we may so cast for things temporal that we lose not the things eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The first reading is from Hosea. When the Lord first spoke through Hosea, the Lord said to Hosea, "Go take for yourself a wife of whoredom and have children of whoredom, for the land commits great whoredom by forsaking the Lord." So he went and took Gomer, daughter of Diblaim, and she conceived and bore him a son. And the Lord said to him, "Name him Jezreel, for in a little while I will punish the house of Jehu for the blood of Jezreel, and I will put him on that day. I will break the vow of Israel in the valley of Jezreel." She conceived again and bore a daughter. Then the Lord said to him, "Name her Lo-Ruhama, for I will no longer have pity on the house of Israel. Forgive my people, it shall be said to them, children of the living God." The Lord, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So we'll read Psalm 85 if you will respond at the asking. You have been gracious to your land, O Lord.
You are the Lord of the Lord of Jacob.
You have forgiven the iniquity of your people.
And blotted out all their sins.
You have withdrawn all your fury,
and turn yourself from your wrathful indignation.
Restore us then, O God, our Savior.
Let your anger depart from us.
Will you be displeased with us forever?
Will you prolong your anger from age to age?
Will you not give us life again?
Let your people may rejoice in you.
Show us your mercy, O Lord.
he finished, one of his disciples said to him, Lord, teach us to pray, as John taught his disciples. He said to them, when you pray, say, Father, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, for we ourselves forgive everyone indebted to us. And do not bring us to the time of trial. And he said to them, suppose one of you has a friend, nothing to set before him. And he answers from within, do not bother me. The door has already been locked, and my children are with me in bed. I cannot get up and give you anything. I tell you, even though he will not get up and give him anything, because he is his friend, at least because of his persistence, he will get up and give him whatever he needs. So I say to you, ask and it will be given you. Search and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened for you. For everyone who asks receives, and everyone who searches finds, and for everyone who knocks, the door will be opened. Is there anyone among you who, if your child asks for a fish, will give a snake instead of a fish? Or if the child asks for an egg, will give a scorpion?
Be the light in this very moment. to do a presentation to Google. He said it looked to him like the average age of the was 30 years old. But he kept being amazed by the building itself, in that there were meditation rooms. So that people could go to in this time that we call prayer is the place where we are recreated and strengthened for what is happening in our lives. Like that is an exterior altar. But the altar we truly seek is not that one. We know exactly where that is. We want to find the altar that is inside of us. That quiet, silent, special place that God has put into the heart of every human being. It's within all of us to be able to reach inside and know that God is there, that God created that connection. And we know in the church that it's that quiet place where we find love and music and dancing. It is communication with our deepest, our deepest self, and communication with God. So what we are, we'll increasingly be about, I feel like in the church, is just how to find that place, how to meditate more, how to pray more, how to be strengthened, how to be created. So I want to tell you right now about someone who wrote about a place like that. Her name is Mary Oliver. Oh, one of the best poets ever. She won the Pulitzer Prize. She was the best selling poet ever in America. She died a couple of years ago from Ohio, outside of the country. A little girl who later said she grew up in a family that was not the best. And so she dealt with that by spending time outside, playing, walking long walks, even when she was very small. Finally putting pencils everywhere outside so that she would have something to write with and write down the thoughts as she walked. Whose poetry was primarily about nature. It's about nature usually for a while, and it's beautiful and you're enjoying it. And all of a sudden you get tripped up and you sit down because you stuck so hard you gotta take care of yourself. And this poem has that too. But it is certainly a poem about seeing deeply and seeing solidly and learning something really important. And then at the end she asks us a big question. The poem is titled "The Summer Day." Who made the world? Who made the swan and the black bear? Who made the grasshopper? This grasshopper, I mean. The one who has flung herself out of the grass. The one who is eating sugar out of my head, who is moving her jaws back and forth instead of up and down, who is gazing around with her enormous and complicated eyes. Now she lifts her pale forearms and thoroughly washes her face. Now she snaps her wings open and floats away. I don't know exactly what prayer is. I do know how to pay attention, how to fall down into the grass, how to kneel down into the grass, how to be idle and blessed, how to stroll through the fields, which is what I have been doing all day. Tell me, what else should I have done? Tell me, what is it you plan to do with your one wild and precious life? Quite an interesting thing, I don't know what prayer is. Maybe for you, who pays that much attention to me? And to whom do I pay that much attention? And behind it all is the knowledge that God is always present, always there, never leaves, never abandons. So you do know that God is aware of you. God is always present. But we don't always know that. We forget that. And when we forget that, we don't do so well. But when we remember, we can get quiet again and figure out how to sit down and be quiet for a few minutes. And we begin to know again who we are and who God is calling us to be as people and as a church. Or what's up for you is to realize that last sentence is important to you. And it's a sentence of prayer. It's a sentence to take into that quiet room and really think about it. Tell me, what is it you plan to do with your one wild and precious life? So you're so important. And you're important to this church that is making it about this learning that we're going to be doing. What do you want to do? You'll know that in the quietness. You'll know that with God. Because the question is, what do you want me to be? So I feel good about us. I feel good about where we're headed and the light that we are. And when Jesus said, look, you are the light of the world, he was right. You are.
Together in your love and reveal your glory to the world. Love God. police officers and first responders. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all those whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Margaret Hunt, Gary Witter, Terry Griffin and family, Bobby H., Sarah Beth, Janet Dupree, Dick Putrell, Terry Harris, Norma Lewis, Katrina Osborne, Kirk Rolfe, Diane Parker, Jim Ross, Dave and Sissy Jankowski, Rusty Bobbitt, Lavonda, Jeanette Goudreau, Janina Lanning, Joel Clark, Gail Smith, Jack Harrell, Charles and Jerry Blue, Sharon Thornton, Alicia Ratsdale, Dave Bell, Suzanne Gavin, Beth Price, Eleanor R., Ryan G. and family, Cheryl McClare, Peter McCook, Rose, Jim Scanlon, Stephanie Dravick, Peter Horton, Roger and Mary Jo Jennings, Art Close, Natasha McCrate, Meg, Sharon, Eric, GGS, Carol Gaffney, Denise Stockport, Dayton Vesper and family, Scott Gunn, Nancy Ward, Pat Webb, and Bob Seymour. Give them courage and hope in their troubles and bring them joy and salvation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We recommend to your mercy all who have died, that you will for them may be fulfilled. Gates Nagel, Reverend David Vesper, Beverly Byer Lynch, Martha Clove Emery, Bob King, John Scarlett, and we may share with all their saints in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In the diocesan cycle of prayer, we pray for St. Joe's Church Fayetteville, with the Reverend Ralph Clark, priest in charge, and Mary Mack Shields. In the ecumenical cycle of prayer, we pray to give thanks for Huggins Memorial Baptist Church in Harper's Island, and Island Church in Ohio. We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life, especially an anniversary for Jay and Betsy Randall of 53. We will exalt you above our King
and praise your name forever.
Thank you. says through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace be with you. Got through the 2 weeks of helping everybody else.
Lord, be with you, and also with you, in the name of your Lord.
out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he gave thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me."
We remember his death. We proclaim his resurrection. We await his coming to glory.
The Lord bless you.